Hey, today we're talking about the eye, the parts of the eye, and how those parts work to help you and me see. The first thing we need to do is talk about how this eye is oriented. The top is the lateral side of the eye, and the bottom of our diagram is the medial side of the eye. Lateral means toward the outside of the body, so this top section here is actually this side of the eye, and the medial section down here is going to be the inside of the eye, closest to the midline. First, we're going to start with a few muscles. You've got one on the medial side and one on the lateral side of your eye, and those are going to move your eye left and right. Next, we're going to draw a line around the eye to outline two things. One is the cornea, and the other is the sclera. The sclera is the white of your eye. Whenever you look at an eye, that white part, the sclera is going to be a protective layer that's going to hold all of the contents of the eye in. You also have the cornea. That's a clear layer that goes in front of the pupil, which is the dark part of the eye, the black circle, and the colored part of your eye. There's a clear layer in front of that. That's the cornea. Next, we're going to label the lens. There's the lens of your eye. This is going to help to focus light onto the retina of the eye. The lens actually will change shape to help you see things that are far away and things that are really close. Up next, we have the colored part of your eye called the iris. I'm drawing the iris right now. This iris in the diagram is green. My irises are brown. Your irises might be blue or green or brown. If you look on the iris, you see these little lines, and that's because the iris can contract and expand. When the iris contracts, it's going to reduce the size of the pupil, the area that light can enter in through the iris, and when it expands, it's going to increase that area. I'm going to draw another picture here that's going to show a front view of an eye. As I'm drawing that, you can see a few things. First of all, you can see those muscles on the medial and the lateral side of the eye. You can see the iris, which I have in green, and you can see the pupil in black. Light that's entering the eye will enter through the pupil. The pupil is not an actual structure of the eye. The pupil is just the hole inside of the iris. And so whenever, for example, you go inside into a dark area, what your pupil is going to do is expand, because your iris is going to expand. And it's going to let more light in. You see that happening in the picture there. And let's say that you go outside where it's really bright out in the sun, your eye is going to get overloaded with light, and so your iris is going to respond by contracting. And so your pupil will get smaller to let less light in. Up next, after the iris, we have the two muscles that are going to help to change the shape of the lens so you can see things far away and see things closely. Those are called the ciliary muscles, and we've got them shown in the picture here and here. Inside of the sclera, there's a layer called the choroid layer. I drew the choroid layer in blue, and the choroid is a vascular layer. It's meaning that it's filled with blood vessels, and that's going to supply oxygen and nutrients to the retina. I'm going to draw the retina in yellow up next here, and it's going to be along the back of the eye. It's a really thin layer and really fragile layer. And that retina is going to contain cells that are going to detect two things. One, they're going to detect light intensity, so how bright is something. And two, they're going to detect the wavelength or the color of that visible light. There's one special part of the retina called the fovea. And most of the rods and cones in your eye are in the fovea. The rods are going to detect the intensity of light, how bright the light is, and the cones are going to detect the color. One way to help remember which is to remember that color and cones both start with a C. That helps me remember that. Most of the rods and the cones in your eye are actually located in the fovea, that little spot right there, that little indention. Whenever you look directly at something, so if you're looking directly at this video right now, the light from the video is entering through the cornea, passing through the pupil, through the lens, and it's focused right onto the fovea. Any light that you see from your peripheral vision, if you see something out of the corner of your eye, that light's going to come in and focus somewhere else on the retina, perhaps up here or down here, depending on where that object is compared to where you're looking. There's one more thing that we're going to label here, and that's called the vitreous gel, or sometimes called the vitreous humor. Humor just means a fluid. And that vitreous gel is going to fill the entire of the eye. It's going to help maintain the pressure of the eye. So if you didn't have that vitreous gel, then your eye would sort of be flat or squished. And it's important that that doesn't happen. Now, if you want to quiz yourself now, you can stop the video and see if you can label all of the different parts of the eye. I've got blanks here for that, and I'm going to go through those now. First, we've got the cornea. That's the clear outer part of the eye that's in front of the pupil and lens and iris. You've got the iris, that colored part of your eye that determines how much light gets in. You've got the pupil, which is a hole in the iris. You've got the lens, which will change shape to help focus light onto the retina. You've got the ciliary bodies that are going to help change the shape of the lens. You've got the vitreous gel, which is going to give pressure to the eye. You have the sclera, the white of the eye, that protects the insides and holds those contents in. You've got the choroid layer, which is going to provide nutrients and oxygen to the retina. You've got the retina itself, which will detect wavelength and light intensity. You've got the fovea. And finally, you've got the optic nerve, which is going to send action potentials or signals from the retina to the brain. And my students will know that that is sent to the occipital lobe of the cerebrum, where images are processed. We can also label on the front view of the eye. We've got the sclera and the iris.
Take a look at how light enters the eye and how it's
focused onto the retina. So let's take a look at some light entering the eye, which I drew here in yellow. And this is light that's coming from an object that you're looking directly at. And that light's going to get focused onto the fovea directly, where the majority of our rods and cones are located. So we're going to see really precisely at that image. Light that's coming in from the periphery, or things that you're not looking directly at, it's going to focus onto the retina as well, but just not right on the fovea. And so our vision's not going to be quite as good there. We're not going to detect color as well, and we're not going to be able to see that image as well, but we'll still be able to see it in our peripheral vision. Finally, let's take a look at how changing the shape of the lens will help to focus light that's far or light that's really close onto our retina. First, let's look at a lens that is stretched too thin. This would be like somebody who is farsighted, meaning that they can see things far away, but they can't see things that are very close up. So light's going to be coming in to the lens, and it's going to focus there behind the retina. You see that it converges here. That's where the light converges. But if you look at where it crosses the retina, it's spread out, and that's going to give a blurry image for things that are close up to somebody who's farsighted. Next, we're going to take a look at somebody who is nearsighted. I'm nearsighted. I have to wear glasses normally. I've got contacts in right now. This lens, if you see it, the lens is wider, and light that's going to be coming into it isn't going to get focused right onto the retina. It's going to get focused or converge before it hits the retina. So by the time that light gets to the retina, it's spread out again and blurry. And like I said, that would be somebody who is nearsighted, like I am. I can't see things very well that are far away. Those are blurry for me. Finally, let's look at somebody with normal vision. And so in this next section, we've got a lens here, and light's going to enter in, and it's going to converge directly onto the retina. And that's going to give a nice, clear, crisp image for the light that you're looking at. That's the parts of the eye and how the eye works. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.